Are you a good hunter? But tired of your weapon? Then you should go to the outfitter's shop. Now the outfitter's shop has all sorts of weapons and armor that you can purchase of your likings. Like for instance, for the weapons, the great swords. You can even preview them. That looks pretty heavy. What about the bone sword? These swords are very heavy and hard to carry, but it makes you swing slow, but it's mighty powerful. And what about this? You may seem to already own that, but you may want to upgrade it. We'll talk about upgrading later. But what about this bone crest? It may be weaker, but it may come to your liking sooner or later. And the mallets. They're the strongest types of weapons that you can choose, right beside a bow gun. But these are for handling and swinging. And there's a bone mallet, just in case you're more like a wildlife endurance person instead of a steel iron person, that's okay. And don't forget about lances, we didn't forget about you. Even though these may seem like the petite type, they sure pack a big sting to the enemy. And there's also a bone choice of lance. Isn't that amazing? And last but not least on the choices, the bow guns. They may be the most expensive type, but they are one of the most effective. Also, you can heal your teammates by shooting these healing pellets at them. Of course, you're gonna have to buy those later on if you buy these. And look at this one. This is the strongest one. It's like a bow gun and a club, but put together in one good matrix harmony. Now, just in case you wonder about upgrading, go to the Wyvern Artist. He knows all about upgrades. Go to Weaponcraft and upgrade. Now, you can go to any weapon that you want. You begin with a huge sword, an iron sword. Just in case you are curious about upgrading that, it shows you the items that you have to upgrade near the bottom left. And if you want to upgrade your small hunter's knife, that's okay too. It shows exactly where it is too. It shows the power on the very left. And you can see a huge power difference, but that's to your likings, not mine. And you can also forge weapons to make weapons come here. What I mean by that is that, like, you can put ingredients in, he can materialize weapons for you. Oh, and it shows you all the previous stuff that we've looked at before. Anyway, so far for that. But just in case you are tired of those old first newbie shruggy clothes, that's okay too. Go back to the outfitter, and she'll fix you up with nice new looking clothes. All you have to do is just go to armor, and simply buy what you want. Hand, chest, arms, waist, and legs. Let's go to chest. Of course, you can preview these, how you would look like with a leather vest or a chain ball vest. Which one to choose? That's to your liking only, not my choice. Next, let's go to the gloves. Of course, leather gloves, classic wildlife enduring. And there's the chainmail gloves. Those really look heavy, and they might do some really good exercise for weights. Now let's go to the waist. Now here, you can buy all sorts of belts. Well, so far there's only two belts of accessories. Leather belt, and the chainmail belt. All the chains look really heavy. And of course, here's the legs. Doesn't that look all Robin Hood? And here's the chainmail pant. And here's headgear, as in like a hat, just in case you were wanting to get away from the sun. And there's a chainmail. It's more like a helmet to me. Oh well. So anyway, if you were wondering to buy anything newest looking, just go to the outfitters. And if you are wanting to upgrade or forge any weapons, go to the Wyvern Artist. They'll help you out nicely.